Sid.
What?
I'd like to have a word with you in confidence.
What's the matter?
It's Bill. I'm worried about him.
Well, what's wrong with him?
Haven't you noticed in these last few weeks? He's changed, Sid. Never seen anyone change so much as he has.
Well, blimey, he's got to change sometime. He can't stay like that the rest of his life.
No, it's deeper than that. He's got something on his mind. He's gone secretive. He slips out at night without telling me. And he's gone off his food. He wouldn't touch his fish cakes this morning.
Do you blame him? Horrible smelly things?
No, well, I smothered him in his favorite chop sauce. He normally has about 7 or 8 of those. Not today, though. Not a nibble. And there he was, sitting behind him, the top of his old head poking above the breadcrumbs. Picture of dejected gloom. I don't know what's wrong with him.
Well, I wouldn't bother. See what he's like tomorrow, and if he's no better, thump him.
Good psychologist you are, aren't you? When will you realize that gone are the days when the panacea for all ills was to fetch the patient a hefty punch up the bracket?
Well, I still believe in it. I can't be bothered with all this modern stuff. Laying on a couch. Did you wake your father? Were you in love with your rocking horse? Get stuck into him. Knock it out of him.
Don't be so primitive. The lad's obviously terribly worried about something.
So am I. 2 of my dogs went down yesterday. But I don't go moping around. I pick up the paper, sort out another couple for today. Life has got to go on.
But some people aren't strong like you, Sidney. They need help. People like Bill are sensitive. They get bewildered by the world. I've always managed to shield him from life, but somehow these last few weeks, I've lost contact with him.
Good. Let's move and lose contact with him altogether.
Don't be like that, Sidney. Show a little consideration for your fellow humans. So unlike him to act this way. That's what worries me. He's always been a happy, laughing Charlie. Nothing bothered him. Stick him in front of a television set with a box of licorice all sorts, he'd stay there till the national anthem. Used to join him with the adverts, singing away there, "Hur, I come up from Somerset, where the fighter apples grow." Yeah. Not now, though.
Perhaps he's fed up with him, like we all are.
No, not him. He hasn't even grasped the technical wonder of it yet. Do you know, he still thinks there's a lot of little actors inside the box. With small cars and little horses. Every night when he thinks I'm not looking, he has a quick glance through the air holes at the back.
Anybody at home?
Shh! That's him. Be nice to him. Don't say anything to him. Watch your step. In here, William. Don't let on we've been talking about him. Just act as if nothing had happened. Be tactful.
Yeah, all right.
Hello, Tub. Sid?
Hey, what's all this mooning about, you miserable rat bag? Brighten yourself up a bit or I'll bang you one.
That's tactful, that is.
Well, what's the matter with you, then?
I'd rather not talk about it.
Well, that's it, then. That's my interest finished.
Sid, why don't you use your loaf? See what you've done now? You've put him on his guard. Closed him right up now.
Good luck. Can't stand these miserable lumbers. As far as I'm concerned, he can pack his boomerang and op it.
Don't take any notice of him, William. I understand. Have you got anything you'd like to discuss with me?
No, I just want you to mind your own business and leave me alone. No one can help me now.
Oh, dear. He's gone all morbid now. See what you've done? He's in the right frame of mind now. So good job we haven't got a river running through the town.
I got a car.
Don't encourage him. Leave him alone. Do you want the television set on, William?
No.
Some good adverts on tonight.
I don't want to see him.
Are you going out tonight?
I don't know.
Are you hungry? You haven't had anything to eat today.
I don't want anything to eat.
Got lots of fish cakes left.
I don't want any fish cakes.
Shall I get your paint box out?
No.
We'll paint the farmyard, shall we?
No.
Do you want to take the clock to bits?
No.
Well, stone me then. What do you want to do?
Nothing.
Go and get your car out, Sid. No, I mustn't be weak. Charity begins at home. I must be tolerant. Just leave him quietly alone. He'll be all right. Just let him sit there.
Oh, on my life, I shall remember that. I did to them.
Don't look at him, Sid.
Well, go, blimey, I got to look somewhere. I don't want to look at him. I just happen to know he's there, and my eyes get pulled round towards him.
Sit with your back to him. He wants to be left alone. Hello, 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 hello. Hello, there goes Mrs. Biggs. There she goes. Look up to the old hand and racket. She'll be there till chucking out time.
I'll have a small treble gin, please, dear.
I got caught one year. I never ask her again.
Wanting you, la da dee da 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 da.
That spider's still up there. I'll get the vacuum over him tomorrow. Good program at the Roxy this week. Two X's and a Tweety Pie. Have a couple of Bobsworth on that on a Tuesday. I got a new ticket tailor down there, you know. She looks very good. Mind you, I haven't seen her with the lights up yet, but all the lads are after her. Must be something there.
How do you get to Gretna Green?
Well, you can get a train from Euston and check. Where?
Gretna Green.
Oh, so that's it. That's what's causing all the misery. A bird's been at him. Of course, I should have realized. Oh, why didn't I think of it? Well, well, well. Fluff trouble. Well, come on then. Who is she? What's she like?
I don't want to talk about
it. Oh, come on. You must tell us now your secret's out.
Tell him the way to Gretna Green and get shot of him.
Come on, Bill. What's her name? How old is she? You've got to tell us about her now. One of us will have to give you away.
Me. Bags, me.
Come on now. Ignore him. Tell us all about it.
Well, there's nothing much to tell. I'm in love.
Oh, isn't that sweet? Hear that, Sid? Bill's in love.
He wants his brains tested.
You unromantic clod. Tell me, Bill, I understand about these things, affairs of the heart. I know what it's like to be in love.
Do you really, Tub?
Yes, oh, yes, yes. Yes, indeed. Cupid's had a go at me on more than one occasion. Not recently, I'm afraid, but there you are. When the petals start dropping off the rose, the bees don't come around so often. Ho-hum.
Oh, no, Tub, you're not so old.
No, no, don't be kind. It's very nice. Who would I know the truth? The young birds aren't interested in men my age, and I'm not interested in birds of my age, so there it is.
But I'm a year older than you are.
Yes, but you've worn better than I have. You can still pass as 25. Sometimes I have my work cut out passing for 45. Still, that's life. I'm not finished yet. I still have me goldfish. But you, Bill, now we know why you've changed so much lately. Love. I'm very happy for you, and I hope the two of you will be. Have you got a handkerchief? I don't often go off like this. Pass us the side of the curtain there. I do apologize. I'm really very happy for you. Don't take any notice of a funny old softy like me.
Oh, get him. What an old woman. A right Joan Crawford.
That's all right, Tub. Anyway, I don't think it's going to work out.
Oh, you poor lad. Is that why you've been miserable?
Yeah.
Doesn't she love you then?
Oh, yeah, she's crazy about me. We're both very much in love, but it's just that, well, it's just not going to work out, that's all. I just don't know what I'm going to do. I've been going out of my mind worrying about it.
worrying what to do for the best. Tom, I don't know what to do anymore.
How do you reckon loppy lugs for the 3:30?
Do you mind? Can't you see this lad's under a very heavy emotional strain? Have a little bit of feeling, please.
What about? A bird is a bird. There's thousands of them. This year, next year, all the time, they're coming and going. There's a new lot every year. Now then, what about loppy lugs? Charlie smokes up, 12 stone 3, hard going, 7 furlongs, should be about 6 to 4.
Nobody's interested in loppy lugs. We're in the middle of a poignant human drama. William's whole future happiness is at stake. At least do him the courtesy of putting down the Racing Gazette for a few moments. Loppy lugs. Now then, William, I don't see why you should be worried. You love her and she loves you. Why bother to elope to Gretna Green?
We've got to.
But why?
Well, her father's against the marriage.
That I can understand.
How old is this lady?
18.
You lucky devil. I haven't been out with an 18-year-old girl since I was... 18. And she wasn't much. Oh, dear, oh, dear. When I look back over the years and think of the rubbish I've consorted with... I've been very unlucky, I have. 18, eh? Yes, that's a problem. If her old man refuses permission, you'll have to wait till she's 21.
I don't want to wait.
I see your point. 3 years can wreak havoc on a man of your age. Strike while you've still got some hair, that's my motto.
Can I go back to my paper now?
He hasn't finished yet.
Look, it's 5 to 3. The race starts in 5 minutes. I've got to phone my bet in. I don't want to listen to all this tripe. I'm just not interested. I don't care who he marries. I just don't want to hear about it.
Take no notice. Why do you think her father is against her marrying you?
Oh, I don't know. He's a big industrialist. Or perhaps it's because he thinks I'm after the £1.5 million that's coming to her.
Oh, that's nonsense. What is £1.5 million compared to true happiness? Does he think that £1.5 million can buy the love and affection of this young... How much?
£1.5 million.
Here's your hat and coat. There's a 4:30 train to Gretna Green arriving at midnight. I'll drive you to the station. I'll book you in at the Thistle for 2 weeks, then you get married, and there's nothing you can do about it. Come on, hurry up, I'll help you pack.
Wait a minute. I thought you weren't interested.
Not interested in my friend Bill? He's been like a brother to me, this boy. And all I want to see is him happily married to the girl of his choice. Bill's happiness means more to me than anything else. I've always looked after you, haven't I, boy? Half a dollar a week I've given you, haven't I?
When?
Here's the first instalment.
Wait a minute. I've looked after him more than you have. Take your hand off his shoulder. Now, he's my friend, not yours.
Look, he's always come to me for advice. I am not going to let you come between two old pals in time of need.
I'm his pal. Let go of him.
Stop pulling my friend's cup.
You let go of my friend's arm.
What have you ever done for him?
More than you have.
All those times you shouted at him, grumbled at him, despised him because he's stupid.
Never. I've never despised him. I've always had nothing but the greatest admiration for him. His intellect has always been a source of constant amazement to me.
He knows who his real friends are. That £1.5 million, Nicker, is that before or after tax?
After tax, I think.
Yeah, well, there you are. He's got room for more than one friend, then.
That's all right, then. A truce, then. We'll cry pax. Shake.
Right, shake. We'll both help him.
Oh, now, wait a minute, fellas. I can't do it. I couldn't ask her to elope with me against her father's wishes.
Then we will get his permission.
How?
Well, I personally, as your guardian, will go round and chat him. I'll speak to him man to man, and I'll explain that the happiness of two young people are at stake, and that we have no right to deny him this. When he sees what class your guardian is, he'll come round all right. Pass me the deerstalker and the Inverness cape, I shall be off. Are you sure this is where he lives?
Yeah.
I didn't know they still had houses this big. I thought it was a street at first. I was looking for a lot of little doors all the way along.
No, it's all his. It's his townhouse, of course, Dunroman. You ought to see his other two places in the country. They're really big.
Yeah, very nice, too. I ought to have a place like this, you know. I was born to this sort of thing. Standing up there on the top of the steps with me Afghan hounds and me handmade double-barrel shotgun under me arm.
Yeah. The upkeep of this place. I wouldn't like to have to replace all that lead guttering.
Well, he won't have to.
He might do.
You don't think very big, do you, Sid? You're a bit tatty, aren't you, really? Let's face it, a bit tatty. Cheap. It's about 3 million quid staring you in the face, and all you can think about is the lead guttering.
Well, let's go in, Tub. Pull the bell handle.
That makes a mockery of that illuminated bell button we've got at home. Shh, quiet, somebody's coming.
Good afternoon.
Ah, good afternoon, my good man. You, I take it, are the lackey.
I am the head butler, yes.
Good lad. Well, will you tell the manager, that is the owner, that there are 3 gentlemen without who wish to be within?
What name shall I give?
Kindly inform him the guardian of his daughter's fiancé is here and wishes to converse with him about the proposed nuptials.
Yes, sir. Would you mind waiting in the hallway? I'll see if Mr. Fenton is at home.
Thank you, my man. Don't hurry. I'll amuse myself inspecting these old masters to see if they're genuine. Oh, yes. Quite a nice Rembrandt they've got here.
Van Gogh.
I thought you'd gone. Now, whatever it is, it's a fake. Van Gogh never painted ear holes like that in his life. Get back to your master, not so much back chat.
Hey, they certainly got some loot here. Are you sure that's a fake? Only if it's not, I can have it out of the frame and down my trouser leg before he gets back.
Don't be so obvious. If this little number comes off, we'll be able to buy our own. William, before I bandy words with the old man, put me in the picture a bit more. Where did you meet this bird?
At the Forest Hills Tennis Club.
You at the Forest Hills Tennis Club? You're not allowed in there without a Bentley. How did you manage it?
I was sweeping the leaves up. I was looking through the wire netting and a ball hit me on the nose. She took me into the clubhouse, gave me a drink, and she fell in love with me.
She must have been half cut before you got there. Has she seen you when she's sober?
Oh, yeah, we've been out together dozens of times since then.
That's a relief. I thought we might have to keep her on the bottle. Now, have you told her anything about yourself?
No, except that I'm stony broke.
Good, that'll leave my fertile imagination enough room to manoeuvre.
What are you going to say, then?
Nothing, nothing, but don't be surprised when we get in there. I might bow a few times and call you Your Highness.
Why?
Quiet. Here comes Arthur Treacher.
Mr. Fenton will see you now, sir.
Merci bien, Mush. Lead on.
In here, sir. The gentlemen are here, sir.
All right. How much do you want?
I beg your pardon?
How much do you want for this person to stay away from my daughter?
I'm afraid your labor under him is happy.
Half a million.
Do you mind? I'm his guardian. My dear sir, I haven't come here to barter with people's lives. I've come here to tell you to keep your daughter away from the prince here.
What are you talking about?
I'll not have Prince William going around with commoners.
Prince William?
Ah, you didn't know that, did you? Yes. You didn't know your daughter was knocking around with royalty. The prince usually goes incognito. He's never been one for flashing his title about, have you, Bill?
No.
Precisely. Democratic to the core.
Prince William of where?
Of where? He's the heir presumptive to the royal throne of Turkestan. Direct descendant of the Kublai Khan. Genuine Mongol blood in him, this boy. Should see him on a horse.
Rubbish. He's a penniless, out-of-work, layabout fortune hunter.
How dare you, by the great beard of Genghis Khan, how dare you speak to the prince like that? If we were back in Samarkand, we could have you thrown off the sacred tower into the crocodile pit for a remark like that. I might tell you it's an honour for you even to gaze upon him. He usually wears a veil for an interview with infidels. He's an Eastern deity, this boy. Back home, the peasants walk for hundreds of miles just to kiss his turnips.
I'm not interested in what the peasants do. My daughter's underage. I refuse to allow her to marry him.
I just told you the government wouldn't let him marry her. He's reserved for a Samarkandian princess, aren't you?
Oh, yeah.
They were betrothed when they were 5. Her father, the Grand Vizier, would have his head off if he was to turn it in now.
Good. Then there's no more to be said. I don't want her to marry him. You don't want him to marry her. We seem to be in complete agreement. Good day to you, sir.
Oh, I see. So that's your attitude, is it? Are you inferring your daughter is too good for His Royal Highness? This could mean war, you realize that?
The man who marries my daughter has got to be able to keep her in the manner to which she's accustomed. She's the heiress to £1.5 million.
Do you think you can buy your way into the aristocracy?
Aristocracy? Him?
Yes, him, mate. He may be penniless, but he's got class. There's 1,000 years of breeding gone into him. Show him how you walk. Move about a bit. Look at that, look at that, look at that. Hey, ho, oh, like an Arab stallion, there he is. Look at him, proud and haughty. Go on, give us a bit of haught. Go on. That's haught, that's haught. You don't see haught like that every day of the week. Look at those flaring nostrils and those ears quivering. Look at that. You can't buy that sort of stuff with money. Now, if you really want blood like this in your family, I could stretch a point and have a word with the government. I could perhaps get the law changed so he could marry a commoner. I mean, they are in love and we want to see him happy, don't we?
For the last time, no. I refuse to let my daughter marry this man. That's all there is to be said.
Very well, then, so be it. You have slighted the royal family of Turkestan. The prince here has lost faith. Definitely. I may warn you that if you are visited in the night by two big Nubians in turbans and baggy trousers brandishing assegais, you have only yourself to blame. Farewell. Come, Prince William. Follow me, Ali, to the embassy.
Well, you certainly messed that up, didn't you?
Well, how was I to know he was like that? I thought all the nouveau riche wanted to marry into the cream.
Now, I'll never be able to marry Constance.
Of course you will. You'll just have to go back to the original plan. Elope with her. Up to Gretna Green, over the anvil, and you're home. You'll be faced with a fait accompli.
A what?
A fait accompli. It's Italian for we got him coal box. Sydney, go and get your ladder, boy. There's work to be done.
Right.
Which one's her bedroom?
The one with the light on.
Stone me, it's 300 foot up.
Oh, it's not.
Well, it looks it. I'm not going up there.
Oh, well, I suppose I'd better go up.
No, no, no. I'm not taking the chance of our chief asset falling down and hurting himself. Sid, go up and bring the bird down.
That's right. I'm not climbing all that way.
You've had the most experience with ladders. Go on, get up there. She knows we're coming. She's waiting for us.
Good luck to her. I'm not carrying other people's women down ladders. She can get on a ladder and slide down.
This'll go against you in the share out.
What share out?
Nothing, nothing, nothing. Hello, she's heard us. The window's going up.
Is that you, darling?
Yes, darling, it's me.
Oh, isn't that sweet?
I'm not quite ready yet. I won't be long. Give me another 2 hours.
We're not waiting out here for 2 hours, madam. Get down that ladder. Look at her. Mink her curlers. How the other half live.
Oh, here she comes. Oh, isn't she beautiful, Tub?
I don't know. Look at that. A special coming down the ladder outfit made by Dior. She'll want to change into her getting in the car and off to Scotland set when she gets to the bottom. Hurry up, madam. Hurry up, dear. We haven't got all night.
Don't talk to my fiancé like that.
Oh, here she is.
William, my darling.
Oh, Constance, oh, Constance.
Come on, come on, we haven't got time for all that nonsense. All this snogging, come on, let's get off. We'll have the whole household up in a minute.
Oh, I can't go yet, there's all my luggage upstairs. Would one of you gentlemen go up the ladder and get it for me? Just a few suitcases and a couple of cabin trunks.
Yes,
and a dozen hat boxes.
Yes.
Oh, two maids.
Look, madam, you're eloping, not going on safari. You'll have to rough it for a few days. You'll have to do without them. Have you got your checkbook?
Yes.
Good girl. Right, we're off then. Sid, straight up the A1 to Haggisland.
Right.
Ah, good morrow, my good kilted Caledonian brother.
You're asking for Muhammad and they said you hid your drink, Sassanash.
What did I say? I was only trying to be friendly.
Aye. Well, state your business and be off. I'm a very busy man.
You are, I take it, the local village blacksmith.
Aye, I am. What can I do for you?
How much for a quick wedding over the anvil?
Well, there's my scalar charges on the wall.
Oh, yes. Horseshoe in 15 shillings a shoe. Wrought iron gates, £30 the pair. Stair rods, 9 pence a foot. Ah, weddings. 7 and 6, 10 and 6, £15, 10. What's the difference?
Well, for 7 and 6, you get the straightforward wedding. For 10 and 6, we throw in a couple of horseshoes for good luck. And for £15, 10, you get the deluxe ceremony, including a full turnout of the police pipe band, dancing in the streets by the villagers, photographs. And a wee drama whiskey after.
Well, it only happens once in your lifetime. It's always something for them to look back on. We shouldn't stint on the ceremony. We'll have the 10 and 6 penny one.
Aye, I thought you would. You look the type.
Give him the money, Constance. This is the bride.
How do you do, ma'am? Who's the tatty bogle?
The tatty bogle? That's the bridegroom.
Oh, poor wee lassie.
Hancock. Hey, Hancock. We've got to get a wiggle on. Get them hitched up and get them out of here.
What's wrong?
They found out where we are. It's all over the newspapers. The old man's just got off the train.
Well, there's no train today.
It's his own. He's on his way over and he's made Constance a ward of court.
What does that mean?
No, nothing, nothing. If we get back to England, you'll be thrown in jail, that's all.
Oh, William, darling, why can't they leave us alone so we can live happy together?
Don't worry, my pet, we'll face this together. I'll fight the world, if necessary, to keep you by my side. Resolute, without flinching. Open and defiant.
You there, leave my daughter alone.
All right. Why, Constance, it's been nice knowing you.
Wait a minute. You're not going to back out like that. Break this poor girl's heart. Stand up for your rights like a man.
You stay out of this. Constance, come home this minute.
I won't. We love each other. Leave us alone so we can live our own lives.
Yes, leave them alone. They have a right to be happy. They're old enough to know their own minds. You can't ride roughshod over the feelings and emotions of human beings.
If she marries him, I'll cut her off without a penny.
You wouldn't do that.
I would, you know.
What, nothing at all?
Not a penny.
Oh. All right, then I'll tell you what I'll do. 1,000 each to break it up.
750.
It's a deal.
Come home, William Kerr. How dare you come between a girl and her father? Do the decent thing. Give her up this minute.
No, I won't give her up.
You cad. What about your wife and 6 children in Australia?
What wife and 6 children?
See, he's forgotten them already. What sort of a father would he be?
You didn't tell me you had a wife and 6 children, William.
Well, of course he didn't. He didn't tell the others either.
There's others?
Of course, he's wanted in every country between here and Australia. Whenever the boat docked, he was straight down the gangplank and into the registry office.
Come on home, Constance. No good can come of this. The Honourable Freddy still wants to marry you. He's not bad looking if he combs the hair out of his eyes. Coming?
Yes, Father, I think I will.
Oh, but Constance, look.
Don't you talk to me. Take me away from here, Daddy.
Come on then, my dear.
Hey, wait a minute, Dad. Aren't you forgetting something? What about the old loot then?
Oh, yes. Who shall I make the check out to?
Me.
Only one of you, if you don't mind.
You put it through my company, Sid James, in brackets, Film Stage and Scrap Metal Limited.
Now, don't just stand there, William. Bend down and let the man rest his checkbook on your back.
I want to marry Constance.
Oh, doesn't he go on? It's all over and done with. You've had it. Stop living in the past. 1,500, that's right. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to do business with you. You haven't got any other daughters, have you?
No, I haven't.
Any nieces, godchildren, anybody you could put us in touch with? You know, it is...
Good day to you, sir.
Yes, of course, yes. A pleasant journey to you, sir. Good health. You couldn't give us a lift back to town, could you? Oh, he's gone.
Do you know what you've done? You've just sold me for £1,500.
Yes, and it was capital gains, tax-free. Do you realise we can do it once more before it's classed as a business? Now, what other girls do you know?
Well, there's the Honourable Barbara.
I don't know anybody else.
Ah, the Honourable Barbara, yes. That sounds loot-worthy. Now, you go down and fetch her. I'll stop up here, and Sid can tell her father the price. We'll form a company, Bill Kerr, Gretna Green Limited. We'll operate from up here, cut down on travelling expenses backwards and forwards. Well, come on, jump about a bit. There's half a Burke's Piers to get through yet. You're not a bad-looking boy. I didn't know I was...